Hi, my name is Austin Purple, and today I'll be giving a 6-minute presentation on solar power. This is a quick overview of the information I'll be covering. So as everybody knows, solar power is basically the conversion of energy that arrives from the sun into a usable power source for us. This gives us an alternative to other methods of power production that is more environmentally friendly. It basically costs nothing to produce and is very reliable. The disadvantages, because all methods of power production have some disadvantages, is that the equipment required has a very high initial cost. Also, there's a limited power density as far as watts per meter squared, and obviously the yield is affected heavily by the weather conditions. So, solar power works using radiation that travels from the sun to the earth. When it reaches the earth's atmosphere, some amount of it is scattered or absorbed, and the rest is transmitted to the surface of the earth. The irradiation that comes to the earth is, we call this S0, it's between 1376 and 1420 watts per meter squared, depending on the time of the year. When we calculate the total power available on the Earth's surface, we use about half of this value because to account for the scatter and the absorption that happens in the Earth's atmosphere. So one method of solar power production is photovoltaics, or also called solar panels. So photovoltaic materials are semiconductors that release electrons when they receive photons. If you arrange cells of photovoltaic material, you can make a panel that will induce a current when it's exposed to sunlight. The efficiency of these panels is affected a lot by the temperature, because as the temperature increases, the internal resistance of the semiconductor increases, and that limits your flow of electric current. So for example, in cold conditions, your efficiency will be about 28%, which is already fairly low. As temperature increases, your efficiency will continue to decrease. So this means the solar panels are really not that effective in certain climates or during the warmer months of the year. This is an example of a solar panel, which I'm sure everyone has seen before. Also, there's an illustration of how photovoltaic materials work, just kind of inside of a photovoltaic cell. Another form of power production is solar collectors. Solar collectors are basically devices that use reflective or transparent surfaces to concentrate the heat from the sun. This concentrated heat is then used to heat up a working fluid to be used in a power cycle, like a Rankine cycle. There are several types. The simplest one is a plane or a flat plate collector. This is basically a transparent surface that holds heat using the greenhouse effect, kind of like an energy trap. Another common type is a focused, or sometimes called a curve, collector. Imagine, you know, a parabolic, sometimes a trough or a bowl type shape, and it's a reflective surface that focuses all of the radiation upon it onto a single point. So this is more effective than a flat plate collector at making high temperatures. And finally, you have heliostats. Heliostats are arrangements of a lot of mirrors that will change position to maintain an optimal reference to the sun. And usually what they do is all the mirrors in this arrangement focus on one single point, so that creates really, really high temperatures. And typically, heliostats will be your most effective form of solar collector. Here's a simple example of a flat plate collector and also a curved focus collector. You can see in each of them the working fluid running through and absorbing heat. Here's an example of a heliostat. In this example, you can see how the working fluid is heated and runs to the turbine to generate electricity. The efficiency of solar collectors is determined by the ratio of the useful heat absorbed to the total heat incident upon it. The useful heat is given where beta is the overall absorbency and CR is the concentration ratio. Also, U is the overall convection of coefficient of convection. So the useful energy is the total heat absorbed minus the heat lost due to convection. The heat gain is simply the incident rate radiation times the concentration ratio. So from that you can see how we derive the efficiency formula. And the efficiency of solar collectors typically will be in the range of about 30 to 40% depending on the type and the weather conditions involved. So in conclusion, solar power is a viable alternative to some of the power production we have now. Because it doesn't burn any fuel, it doesn't release anything into the atmosphere, and it doesn't consume resources, so it's very ideal from an environmental standpoint. The efficiency of most solar devices is pretty relatively low, but it's a continuing field. Research is kind of pushing, and hopefully in the future, the solar power devices will have higher efficiencies, which will make it a more practical source of power.